Hey guys, I've had several requests from you to talk about Zoom and give you some Zoom tips. So I'm going to share with you like four or five tips in the next couple minutes that's super important when you use Zoom. Number one is the lighting. You want natural light, if possible, coming in. You can see light coming off me. Now you see a little bit of shadow here. I wouldn't suggest that. It's just the time of day. But you can see that I have nice light coming in, makes my face look good, versus if I go to the dark side and I get into dark stuff, look at my eyes, they look hollow and scary. So you don't want to be using and facing dark. It doesn't help. And then you can see the light in the background, that's no good either. So you want to do natural light, it's important. If you don't have natural light, you want to get a ring light. Take a look at that, it's right there. That's a ring light. You can get it on Amazon Prime. Mr. Tyson told me to do that. And that you can put on the side of you, on either side, depending on what the light is like. So lighting is critical, especially if you're doing a buyer presentation or you're doing a listing presentation. You have to pay attention because otherwise you look weird and then you get funny shadows, right? The second thing you gotta get is your background. Background has to be neutral. See, you can see the background behind me is neutral. The other thing that you don't want is this. See that door open? There's pillows. Oh, maybe that's a little laundry back there. No, you don't want laundry in your back. People are looking behind you, especially when you're sitting there one-on-one trying to do a presentation, like I said, or with a buyer. So make sure the background is clean, simple, doors are closed. The other thing that's super cool is that you can use what's called a green screen. And you saw Tyson when he presented to us, he had a cool green screen. It doesn't mean it's green. It's a screen that goes behind you, not literally, but through Zoom, that you can put the Jay Barrett logo on, and it's just neutral and it's awesome. Anne-Marie can help you with that. The other thing that I'll say, number three, that's super important is your body language. So when you're communicating in Zoom or in person, we know effective communication is 55% body language, 37% your tonality, and 7% are the words. So you have to watch your body language, which no one ever thinks of when they're doing Zoom. So what happens is a lot of people, they have their camera like this, or it's like this, or you're looking like down like that versus right in the camera. And people are like, whoa, what are you doing? The other thing that people do that I notice is that you move a lot, okay? You move a lot when you're doing Zoom, which everyone's looking going, wait, what are you doing? Obviously, you're not gonna move when you're doing a presentation. But when you're doing a presentation, watch your hands. Now watch this. Look at how big my hand looks, ugh. So a lot of people are like fixing, or they're playing, and oh, what about this? How do I look? So because we're not used to looking at ourselves. So. Number three tip is that you've got to watch your body language. It's very important and it's very distracting, okay? The last thing I'll say today is screen share. You can use screen share with Zoom. It's hugely effective when you're doing and presenting on a listing presentation. So I think I've probably talked to probably 20 of our agents that have actually done a Zoom listing presentation. And so you can share the screen. You can actually go in and show the number of bedrooms, number of baths, square footage, etc. And with Zoom, there's like a little marker that shows how to do it. And it's very effective. If you watch Tyson's presentation, he did it tremendously. The key is you must practice. All of this takes a little bit of talent, not that much. But you have to practice your screen share. You have to practice, you know, not doing this. And by the way, with body language, stop touching your face. We're living in a germ-free time, okay? So there's some great things that you can work on, but practicing is the key. So you have to practice. Practice with your kids, practice with your family, but make sure you take these tips and you implement them, because that's how you have a great presentation via Zoom. Have a great day, guys.